Duquesne. The winners to meet on Monday night. Hi again, everybody, and good morning. You don't get a chance to say that every day in college sports. I'm Dave O'Brien, my partner Doris Burke. Great to have you with us, Doris. At any hour, they will rise here in the state of Connecticut to see the terrific Breanna Stewart play. Her career is starting to wind down. It's been some career.
Well, in as quiet and unassuming fashion as one possibly can make the statement, she said 4 years ago when she came here, I want to win four national championships. Well, she and her teammates are just six games away from truly extraordinary history. And the only thing, Dave, that has piled up higher than those national championships are the individual accolades. The most difficult matchup in college basketball has accumulated. The only player to win three most outstanding players, one championship away. But make no mistake, she has two of the best players at their respective positions contributing in great fashion. Mariah Jefferson is a defensive dynamo, and Morgan Tuck's versatility on the defensive end of the floor helps this team immeasurably.
Of course, under Gino Auriemma, the charismatic Hall of Famer has already won more basketball titles than anyone in women's history. And with an 11th title in April, he would pass a coach he reveres, the great John Wooden, for the most by a head coach in NCAA history. Now look at the Capital One starting lineups now for UConn. Stewart joined by Jefferson and Tuck, all three trying to win four national championships. Nurse and Samuelson go 6 feet and 6'3". For Robert Morris now, four of the five starters are internationals. Stamalampreou is the star. She's from Greece. The point guard, Ashley Ravelli, is from Italy. So at times, their starting lineup sounds more like a soccer team from Europe. There's Coach Sal. Sal Buscaglia, and he is in his 13th year and his 38th season as a head coach. And Sal's final season as a head coach, he's retiring and giving the job to his son, Charlie, the associate head coach on the staff. We are set for the opening tip. Nice crowd on hand, certainly for 11 in the morning. To get a look at Breanna Stewart and Morgan Tuck and Mariah Jefferson and 32-0 UConn, undefeated and riding a 69-game winning streak. UConn winning the opening tip, and we're underway. Up top, Tuck with a touch. Miss Samuelson really been hot shooting the ball. Stewart off the fake. Tuck cross court into the corner for Nurse. Gets it started with a three-pointer.
Oh, what a possession. Terrific patience. Multiple players touch the ball, Dave, and you get an uncontested deep corner three for Nurse. Good start for UConn.
Robert Morris coming in at 20-12. Very highly successful program. They are the champions of the Northeast Conference. Trying to get it down low. Well done to Megan Smith. She's got good size at 6'1".
Yeah, she's their second leading scorer. And she also draws the assignment defensively of Stewie.
Samuelson burying a three. And after a cool start to her college career, she is tearing it up from three.
This is a player who I think would take a major step and fill the void in terms of star power season from now. And Samuelson is a big-time player, and I think before this tournament is all said and done, that young woman is going to have a big-time moment.
Here's Lou Maddeley from Toulouse, France. Has it beyond the three, shot clock down to seven. The drive and the scoop, but denied by UConn in the lane. And now Jefferson, 13 points, five assists a game. Here's Stewie, and off the front of the iron. And a reach and a whistle. A foul will go against Samuelson. Now she's been in the starting lineup since the middle of January. You can really trace the improvement in her performance to that point forward, coming in averaging 11 points a game. The last eight games, Samuelson is hitting over 50% from three.
Well, I think it was just a matter of her getting comfortable. This is a player who was out of high school, a terrific shooter.
Stamalampreou off target from three. She comes in averaging about 14 a game. And so much of the offense for Robert Morris, the Colonels, will go through her. Turnover. Stewart on the bounce to Tuck. A foul on the play, and she'll be at the line. The foul will go against Ashley Ravelli.
Well, a career high in steals this year for Brianna Stewart. She's at 53, and this is something we did not see when she was a freshman, sophomore, or junior. The ability to shoot the gap, Dave, and make no mistake, it has not been without its pain, because Gina Auriemma has been relentless in asking her from her freshman year on to be better on that end of the floor.
Orgetuck averaging 13.6 rebounds. Just two double-doubles this season, though. She always looks like a double-double waiting to happen. She's had knee problems throughout her career, and oftentimes they have to wait to game time to figure out how she feels.
Right, and her practice time has been limited periodically throughout the year. She has got a terrific handle on her body, though, Dave, and she dictates how much activity goes on.
Robert Morris into the tournament for the fourth time, the second time in 3 years. And trying to pull off the upset of upsets today, but an 8-2 lead for UConn. They weren't talking about upsetting Connecticut. They were just talking in their huddle yesterday at practice. Shot clock down to 3 and a traveling violation. And Doris, I know you were impressed by this. They were saying the right things about what today will mean for them.
You know what Sal said to his group? He said, listen, our program is about playing hard regardless of what the scoreboard reads. And he said, if we take a charge with 4 seconds left in that game, he said, I'll be as proud of you in any win we've had this season. So I think that speaks to what their program is about. You could make the same case for UConn, right? It's never about what's on the score. It's about a level of expectation. That's what makes great coaching to me.
UConn winning by an average of 40 points per game. Over the top for Samuelson. She'll finish that off. She has 5 quick points here. Nice give there from Kia Nurse in transition. Kia relentlessly upbeat.
Now, Connecticut, as you can see, this is a team that all of a sudden is willing to apply pressure in the half court or in the full court. And if they turn you over, which is very difficult for teams not to do against that pressure, it gives them a numbers advantage and easy opportunities.
Robert Morris, a school of about 5,100 students, located just outside of Pittsburgh. There's Tuck with the theft. She picks it clean. Can't finish it, though, but there's Samuelson again. He's off to a nice start.
Yeah,
got to get a timeout here.
Big time.
That's 7 points for Katie Lou Samuelson. UConn doing what UConn does. On top very quickly, 12-2.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented.
Connecticut forces their opponents into over 21 turnovers a game. How do you do it? Well, you jump the passing lane. If you're Stewie, you just tip it, allow your teammate to get it. You're in a 3-on-1 situation. A quick trap over on the sideline. Morgan Tuck reading the activity of her teammates. Samuelson, a nice job to run the floor. And one of the things that makes their defense so special to me is, one, they're fundamentally sound, but two, they have finished over the last 3 years first or second in terms of number of fouls. That means they don't put their roster in jeopardy, right? This is not the deepest team. May the fourth be with you. That's
I like that, yeah.
And Dave, the other thing is they don't put their opponent at the line to get easy opportunities, free throws. That's crucial.
Stamoulopoulos with the 5th turnover already for Robert Morris. And for Coach Sal, you made a great point. We were chatting during the break as he's in his huddle. What is he saying?
Right.
Here you are at Storrs, Connecticut, facing a 32-0 team with a 69-game winning streak, a heavy favorite to win an 11th national title. What are you telling your kids?
Right. Listen, this is a case where Coach Buscaglia knows his team is overmatched. So this isn't as much about what the score is right now. It's about trying to get his kids to relax a little bit, handle the pressure, not turn it over.
Megan Smith with a foul, her first. Inside for Tuck, gonna power way up and draw the foul. So she'll be at the line here in the first quarter. 6:29 to go. This year, women's basketball, just in case you're tuning in for the first time and seeing a women's game, starting off with the tournament, has gone 2-4 quarters. And there are many who believe it's just a matter of time before the men's game goes to 4 quarters.
I love the flow of it, Dave. The pacing of the games. I would hope that the men go to 4 quarters. I would really like to see across all levels of basketball in the United States and beyond, there be one set of rules for everybody. I mean, maybe you could change the distance of the 3-point arc on the women's side, but I'll be honest with you, I would like to see a more uniform game.
Ravelli calling out a play from Milano, Italy, the emotional team leader for the Colonels. been a very successful program, having a tough time here where Stewie leads the break and lays it in. But Coach Sal has won over 700 games in his career. He's been an outstanding coach.
It's really kind of a neat story that his son has been beside him for so many years and will take over in his absence next year.
Jones trying to follow her own miss, hits the deck, but traveling with it. Jocelyn Jones, a sophomore, and it's 7 turnovers for the Colonels.
You know, and I asked Charlie, his son, Sal's son, I said, what's the thing that you'll remember most about your dad and his coaching career? He said, you know, when I was a kid, and he said, my dad had to spend an inordinate amount of time with his team, and then even when he was with me, Samuelson gets a look at three, even when he was with me, you know, his mind was very often on coaching. He said it wasn't until I became a Division I head coach that I understood, Dave, the responsibility that has been on his shoulders. So that's kind of a cool little deal for his son.
Indeed. Samuelson tips that one out of play. Talking to Sal yesterday, father and son on the bench, I said, what do you wish for your son? He said that he just has a great career and has a great time.
Yeah, I love it.
Jefferson going for the theft and out of play. Mariah Jefferson, because of the brightness of Stewart's star, it gets lost that should UConn win the national championship, Jefferson and Morgan Tuck will join her as the only players to be on 4 national championship teams.
Well, you and I called that national championship. I know Stewie has won 3 straight most outstanding players. We felt like Jefferson could have equally have been that player.
Oh, a terrific play by Samuelson, but she really took a hit as she went down, and she's holding the side of her head. Made the shot, but she's really in pain right now. That was a nasty fall, and needing a little bit of help to get to her feet. And waving off the bench. I'm trying to shake that up. Nice to see her smiling after that.
Well, that's a kid who wants no part of checking out of the NCAA tournament game. In transition, just the catch is terrific. Defender comes below her, and because she can't break her fall, she takes a pretty good knock.
Katie Lou Samuelson at the line, 83%.
Do you absolutely love that this kid's playing in her first NCAA tournament game? She's looking at the bench going, there is no shot you're taking me out.
And you know what? Her teammates didn't want her out of the game either.
They
got her, on her feet like, you're okay, you're okay. 19-2 UConn, and just great pressure by Nurse and everybody else.
It's interesting, you know, you're putting Samuelson at her size, Dave, at the front of that pressure. And I will say this, from the time we saw them early in the year, Samuelson has got a much better handle on what they're looking for from her on the defensive end.
Ravelli on Samuelson. That's 5'7 against 6'3. Stamalampru, 5'9 junior from Greece, and picked off. Here comes Jefferson. So lightning fast for 2 more. And it's gotten ugly very quickly.
Yeah, this ability to be in the passing lanes consistently is problematic for Robert Morris.
Foul will be on Stamalampru.
Watch the closing speed of Mariah Jefferson. We have seen her be the most impactful player on the floor on many occasions with her defensive abilities and speed. And that's an example right there.
So Nurse will be at the line. What an amazing family athletic tree for Kia Nurse, the sophomore from Hamilton, Ontario. Averaging 9 points per game coming in. And as Samuelson heading to the bench with 10 points. And a little chat with the Hall of Famer. Tipped out of play, and it seems like every single time Robert Morris tries to make a pass, somebody gets a fingertip on it or they throw it away.
Yeah, 11 turnovers here in the first quarter with 4.5 to play.
Cross court tuck wide open. She likes that shot, but too strong. Stewart will run it down. Now the drive and lays it in.
Boy, how about the pass from Morgan Tuck? That was just perfectly placed. I don't think it stayed on Morgan Tuck's fingers for more than an instant. That was beautiful.
It's Demolefru in the lane, and that'll rattle in. Just 4 points for them here in the first quarter. Williams to the left. Can't connect. Tuck right back up and a miss, but tips it out. Jefferson open. She'll launch it. And stick the three. But they move it so beautifully to the open shooter.
Well, it's an unselfish team. You look at the number of assists per game. It's never about any one individual at UConn. It's about the collective group.
Jones with a misfire. 5'10 sophomore, very quick, very athletic. Here's Tuck on the other end, and one, she'll be at the line. Fouled by Jocelyn Jones.
Well, they are out in transition, but they are as good a passing team as you'll find in the country. Watch what happens on the catch here from Morgan Tuck. She's going to read that Stewie's got an angle on the back door. That defender is too topside. It doesn't stay on Tuck's hands for more than a moment. That is beautiful basketball.
A rare miss at the foul line for UConn. You realize they are shooting as a team 80% at the foul line?
You know, when you're playing these first round games, obviously there's such a talent differential between these two teams. But one thing you're looking for if you're Connecticut, and our women in the studio talk about this all the time, Kara and Rebecca, you want to know, Dave, is your game sharp? Are you comfortable? Did the layoff have any effect? I don't think so.
Another tip pass. It does reach Madeley, but then stolen away by Jefferson. That's 12 turnovers already with almost 3 minutes to go in the first quarter for the Colonels of Robert Morris. 32-4. Inside, Stewart just shredding the defense. Right down the lane. Boy, this might be the quickest 30-point lead in recent NCAA tournament history. Tuck with another big rebound. She's averaging about half a dozen a game. And of course, if not for all the blowouts by UConn, she'd have a lot more because she comes out of game so quickly. Here's another three, and that one is on target.
Yeah, you know, her percentage from three, Tuck, is not as good as her form would indicate. But what I love about her, she doesn't hesitate. And I think she's got great belief that those percentages are going to come up.
UConn, the 10-time national champs, and half of those, they finished undefeated. And they're trying to do the same thing this year. Ravelli, harassed, can't hit it. Here's Nurse leading the break. Stewart beating everyone to the other end for two more. And Buscaglia has to call a timeout. 39-4. Goodness. Now the NCAA Women's Championship continues on ESPN2 today at 1:30. First round action. You'll see coverage of Iona and number 2 Maryland. That's a Maryland team that is going to be a handful against anybody they play. Brenda Freeze's teams always are. Number 12 Middle Tennessee State taking on Florida State. Then it's Purdue, Oklahoma. And we have Duquesne against Seton Hall. That's the 9-8 game.
I agree about Maryland. Oklahoma under Sherry Cole is always one of the better offensive teams in the country. But what a dominant performance by the Connecticut Huskies. And Brianna Stewart, the reigning player of the year, out in transition at 6'4", long arms, ability to finish with either hand at the rim. Beautifully done.
They're shooting 67% here in the first quarter.
They're slacking a little bit, huh?
A little bit. Well, it's early. Started at 11 a.m., and that one just mishandled by Janae Brown, a 5'8 junior, the backup point guard. Her dad played in the NFL, J.B. Brown. He's a cornerback. He played for the Dolphins, the Steelers, and the Lions.
Robert Morris, after opening the game in a man-to-man, has dropped to a 2-3 zone. Feels like the first time they've been able to set up their defense, right? UConn's been playing off turnovers and misses.
Over
and, in
and over, yep.
Yeah.
Jefferson, that blocked cleanly. Wormack got a fingertip on it, and out of play it goes. So a nice defensive play, the best of the game so far, certainly for Robert Morris. School is named after one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence, who helped finance the Revolutionary War with his own line of credit and then went bankrupt. He died in a debtor's prison.
That is incredibly unfair.
Isn't it? He'd be delighted to know the team's GPA is 3.60.
That's a great point.
The very smart basketball team. A whistle on the floor with 50 seconds to go before the second quarter, and 39-4 UConn. Robert Morris played Notre Dame a couple of years ago in the tournament. Collier with the foul. And Nurse will return. And Jefferson will step out. One of the remarkable things about the Connecticut fan base is, regardless of the score, they stay and watch and they follow with great passion.
Yeah. I know Juno Auriemma, about a month ago, when it was looking like, obviously, they were going to host this first and second round, was pleading that his fan base show up because, of course, the regional, should they advance, is in Bridgeport. And he didn't want his fans waiting until then.
Yeah, the regional round. Stewart, the All-American. Brandon Stewart, right now the number two all-time scorer here at UConn, and she'll draw the foul with 14.6 to go in the first quarter.
I should know that if you go into Revolutionary War history in the first quarter, things are getting out of hand.
Just a tad. Stewart at 82%. As mentioned, it's right about the average at the foul line for the entire team. They are number one in the country in foul shooting at 80%. She now has 10 points. UConn with a 69-game winning streak. It's the fourth longest in NCAA history. Of course, they hold the record at 90. The UCLA men had won 88 in a row, and those comparisons continue. Just taken away on the block by Brianna Stewart.
First 10 minutes in the book. Huskies, no hangover from a long layoff between the American Conference Championship and today. The defending national champion has come out firing. It's come from all positions. Nurse, Stewart, Jefferson to Stewart. Huskies rolling. They got lots of bite.
Ad ora giocare a basket per la Robert Morris. Forza Colonials.
Χαίρομαι πολύ που παίζω για το RMU. Πάμε Colonials.
Με encanta jugar para el equipo de Robert Morris. Vamos Colonials.
J'adore jouer pour Robert Morris. Allez Colonials.
We talked about the international flair for this team and four of the five starters coming from foreign countries. I love playing basketball for Robert Morris. Go Colonials.
How about
each of them said.
Yeah, the top three scorers from Greece, Canada, and Italy, respectively.
Very elegant sounding team. Maybe not at this moment.
And listen, at their level, there are tremendous pieces on this team. They don't come out of their conference without those pieces, obviously.
Samuelson will be at the line already with 10. Fouled by Navarro.
And for the father-son coaching tandem, I asked Charlie, you know, what will be different about your reign compared to your father's? And he said, you know what's interesting is I am somebody who craves structure. I want our team to have the same routine. If we decide we're not going to talk at pregame meal, let's not talk at any pregame meal. And his dad, he said, my dad's greatest strength as a coach has been his ability to adjust over time, to recognize he had an exhausted success at one program, move on to the next spot. I just think it is really cool that for so long, father and son have been able to do this job together, and Charlie will take over in his absence.
712 wins for Coach Sal. And his career certainly looking like it will come to an end here today at Storrs, Connecticut. That one taken away by Tuck, but a foul from behind. That'll go against Mulrain, the sophomore from Ontario, Canada.
If there is a friendship between Sal, Charlie, and Gino, because on the road once, Gino was standing in an airport. Charlie, the associate head coach, was he had a ride all delivered. Gino's like, hold on a second. I'm a multiple-time national champion, and I don't have a lift, and you do?
I can't get a ride in Chicago? Samuelson drills another three off to a great start today with 15. Her shot never got to the point where it looked ragged or anything, but so much more confident now here in these last games.
Yeah, you know, she carries herself different, right? Shoulders are back, head is high. She tries to close out on a shooter. Nicely done.
Navarro, who's a pure shooter, she hits 45%. She's a 5'11 junior from Spain. Amber Morris just trying to get into double figures, and they pick one off here.
Good defense by Stamolampou. Really good job, activity at the top of that zone, forcing a turnover.
It's the first turnover here today for the Huskies. Ravelli. Shot clock down to 13 for the Colonels. Navarro dangerous beyond the three-point line. Better get one started here. Stamolampou. Trying to get by Williams. Airborne. Right in front of the shot clock. And picked up by the Huskies.
She might have gotten away with a walk there.
Collier, I think, did, but lays it off. And up and in for Samuelson. Now 17 points. And she is shaking off that hit she took.
Yeah, no question about it. And, you know, it's interesting. You were talking about her struggles early, Samuelson. When a shooter can't get shots to fall, especially when you're a freshman, I think that can have an impact on your confidence. But good patience from her. And I think Gina Oriam has probably expended some energy coaching her up over the course of this season.
Well, it has clicked. There's so many things Coach Oriama does. Airborne shot, a wild shot by Ravelli. Comes free to Nurse. She wants to push the tempo. Tipped away and a nice stop there.
Samuelson on the move, Dave, needed to drop a left-handed bounce pass. Instead, she puts it right where the defender's hand was. If she threads that with a little bounce pass, that's another deuce.
Coach Oriama will get Jefferson and Stewart back in the game here in a moment. Here in the second quarter, this will go the other way. A foul will be on Robert Morris. Now coming up, the NCAA Wrestling Championships at Madison Square Garden. Catch the finals at 8 on ESPN, a special off-the-mat coverage on ESPN3, and visit NCAA.com, the home for all 90 NCAA championships.
I got my brother tickets to that. He's a former high school referee for wrestling. I know your son was a wrestler himself.
My boy Mike was. Tough shot there. Stewart's almost rolled in. She'll be at the line. Fouled by Moraine.
Foul number 21.
And two coming for Brianna Stewart. I think about her leaving this stage. For me, anyway, it's a lot like when the great Brittany Griner departed college basketball and the giant impact they both made. And then you're wondering what happens after they leave this stage.
Well, I think she's prepared for greatness, to be perfectly honest with you, is to try to capture or put into some perspective. Already a three-time NCAA champion, has done what no other player has been able to do, win that most outstanding player three times. There's been so much discussion about where she fits in the great lineage of Connecticut basketball. If she does something unprecedented, then she's going to have to be put at the top of the list.
She's done something unprecedented today. She has taken over the all-time lead in block shots from everybody's All-American, the great Rebecca Lobo, blocking two shots early in this game. So a new record for Brianna Stewart. Picked off by Samuelson. Over the top for Jefferson. Trying to beat the defense. Can't do it. Collier has that one knocked away, but wins it back.
Yeah, Jones able to sprint in transition. That's what I'm talking about with Robert Morris. Yes, it's 50-7, but are their kids running hard in transition, doing their best to keep up? Yes.
Collier on the baseline, got a great look. Stewart went over the back, and that'll be a foul. And that will go against Robert Morris and against Jones. So here's the history for Brianna Stewart. With another block shot, had two of those right away. So she has passed Rebecca Lobo for the all-time school record. And we have Rebecca from the studio to try and rub it in a little bit. Rebecca, great to have you with us. And first of all, right away, your thoughts on someone jumping past you in the record book. That's the competitor we love right there. That's Rebecca Lobo, who would tear your heart out for a rebound.
Hey, Rebecca, I have to ask you, because I know you were at the practice where Gina was being relentless about Brianna Stewart's inability to defend to the level that he wanted her to. Can you just describe, probably knowing the experience, how hard that is on a player? Because Brianna's been coached relentlessly here.
Thank you.
So many great players here at UConn. You were certainly right there at the top of it. We talk about this list of players. Where would you, and you're on this list, Rebecca, where would you rank Breanna Stewart in UConn history? It would be really hard not to put her number one with four national titles. You're always going to be right there near the very top of that list for us, Rebecca. Thanks for joining us here this afternoon. We appreciate it very much. Actually, it's still morning. It's like 11:35.
Hey, she wore 5-0, but she's number one in our hearts. I'll tell you that.
She's the best. Jump shot on target by Jocelyn Jones, the sophomore.
And I would tell you this, I completely agree. And I'm very biased toward Diana Taurasi just because she is one of my favorite players in basketball history, regardless of gender. I think she is by far the most accomplished women's basketball player in history. As Jefferson hits another three, I don't know if I could move her past D in terms of the best ever.
Even with the four championships that she wins for?
I know. I agree. Wow. Listen, it's special. It is special. She's got a long way to go before she wins European championships, the number of Olympic titles that Diana has won. If we're talking specifically just about UConn, then yes.
It's a pretty good debate, and it's a debate you'll hear in this gym virtually every day, every time UConn plays. 58-9, the lead over Robert Morris. Love it. Have no idea, Kev, what that may be, because she seems to do everything, including what she's doing today, exceptionally well.
I'm going to make a guess that it's baking something. Maybe she can't bake.
Wriggling inside Jones. She'll draw the foul with 4:15 to go here in the second quarter. UConn leading in points off turnovers, by the way, 33-0.
How good is it to see those three back at studio ready to go? Tipped it up yesterday. Long day for them today.
Yeah.
As well. That's a brutal stretch for them.
They look downright spiffy. Foul by Natalie Butler.
Did you see that studio group at the end of every year, Richard Deitch from Sports Illustrated does his rankings of various kinds of coverage in sports, and he put them as honorable mention, and they're up against some big time competition. The NBA studio show on TNT, also our game days on college football. So great compliment to that group back at studio, Kevin, Kara, and Rebecca, deservedly so.
That's 20 turnovers already for Robert Morris. And they have yet to get into double figures here with about 4 minutes to go in the first half. Jefferson, she can hit that three at 39% out there. And a foul inside as they're trying to contain Natalie Butler, who is 6'5", the Georgetown transfer, became active only at the end of December. And she will be at the line, 61% at the foul line. Sophomore out of Fairfax Station, Virginia. Second round coverage of the Division I Men's Basketball Championship continues today on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on game times and listings, go to NCAA.com.
Miami and Wichita State will face off in Providence, and the Providence College Friars will take on the North Carolina Tar Heels down in Raleigh. I'm going to say it, I'm not covering the men's tournament, go Friars.
Michigan State has been eliminated.
Yeah.
And there goes your bracket.
Nope, many people had them favored to win the entire thing.
Yep. Tuck on the wing. Butler commanding it down low. Looking for help out of the double team, and she travels with it. The winner of this one taking on the winner of Duquesne and Seton Hall, the 8-9 game coming up.
It'll be very interesting to see how Connecticut and Gino Auriemma handles the rest of this basketball game. Obviously, second game in this region here would be on Monday night, I believe about 7 p.m. You know, how much do you use Stewie? You have got, you know, the rest versus staying sharp in the second half.
He's going to put Nabisa Collier back in the game, the freshman. So he is mixing it up. He has Sanaya Chong in now. Jefferson's got a great look, but off the rim. Out of bounds there on the baseline with 2:55 to go in the quarter. A look at our bracket. And it'll be Monday night. The winners will be advancing to square off in the second round.
Now you've got one of the outstanding players in the country at Michigan State, Ariel Powers, scoring dynamo. Remember the individual matchup she had earlier in the year with Rachel Bam of Minnesota. Just great individual back and forth.
Into the corner here for Madeline, and she'll knock in a three. Senior from France who has twice blown out her ACL. It's been quite a story. And they finally get into double figures. Chong off the fake, but she dragged the foot. That'll be a traveling violation.
That's another interesting piece for me is Sanaya Chong. All season long, I was at one of their first practices. Gino Auriemma was talking about an IT band injury that Sanaya Chong has been dealing with all season. She's sort of been a little bit in and out of the lineup periodically, low minutes.
She can shoot that long-range shot, really helped them on occasion.
No question. And as we've talked about, the one thing you would say is they're not the deepest team in Connecticut history.
In heavy traffic, Moraine couldn't get it up there. Stemmel-Emprude buries the three, still firing it up there.
Well, you know, this is a player who had 67 made threes coming into this game with 108 assists. So Stemmel-Emprude has had her signature all over this season for this team.
She's the Colonel's top player, averaging 14 points a game. Here's their first three. Here's Chong. Not there, and it's into the corner. And out of play, back over to Robert Morris. Seven of their 14 players on the roster are international players.
And the first one was a player by the name of Vega Martinez out of Spain. And essentially, that is how they got Rebecca Navarro. And remember, European basketball, those players know one another. So word of mouth spread that Robert Morris was a terrific place to play in the United States.
Jones with a tough angle shot that won't drop in. UConn trying to go to 33-0 and also tie one of their own records for winning streaks. It's 70 consecutive, which is the second longest. They have the number one all-time record at 90 in a row. Collier chasing it down. Shot clock's down to 7. Williams spinning into the lane, but before the shot, a foul with 59 seconds to go. Madeline with the personal.
Do you not love, though, that Jocelyn Jones hits the deck trying to chase a loose ball? And again, this is how Robert Morris will define themselves.
They have 9 players averaging 11 minutes or more per game, so it's a deep roster. As Williams hits, he makes 77%. Something of an unsung hero for UConn. But the number 2 rebounder, despite playing only 19 minutes a game. 62-15.
I think, you know, Gabby is their definitively the best athlete on their team. And growing, you know, the faith this staff has in her, the trust they're starting to place in her is growing.
Pretty good look by Stemmel-Emprude, but it won't drop from 3. And into the final seconds of the first half, UConn got off to an absolutely blazing start, a surgical start, just picked the Colonels apart in the opening minutes. And it just added on and added on. Collier with the bucket to make it 64-15.
Connecticut backing off their pressure. And they did it about midway through this quarter. And now in a 2-3 zone.
The kick out for Ravelli. Up top, Jones lets fly, but off the front of the iron. And that'll be the end of the first half. What a half for the defending national champs. Katie Lou Samuelson spent most of that second quarter on the bench, but still at 17.
Now what a half for the freshman. She went down hard in transition, didn't miss a beat, made the free throw, shook it off. And this is what she came in known as, Dave, the three-point shooter.
Kevin Negandhi and the Northwestern Mutual halftime report next. Boy, the Huskies were everywhere there as we welcome you back to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. Our score as we get set for the second half, UConn 64 and Robert Morris 15. So a 49-point lead. Dave O'Brien and Doris Burke with you, triggered by great defense, DB, and 20 turnovers that UConn forced.
They come in averaging, forcing over 21 turnovers. They've got the best player in the country. And what a start on the defensive end as a unit, and in particular by Brianna Stewart. She had 6 steals to go along with 15 points and 4 assists. I'm not sure what else she could have done. A good trap by her teammates. She jumps a passing lane, gets an easy basket. She was debating throwing that thing to Mariah Jefferson, but terrific cut. The pass by Tuck was beautifully done. How about the ability to handle that ball in traffic, multiple defenders around her, and then this, the anticipation. I just cannot get over the difference of her on the defensive end of the floor.
Katie Lou Samuelson leading the way with 17. She was 6 for 8 from the field. Brianna Stewart with 15 points, 4 assists, 6 steals and 2 blocks. And Mariah Jefferson pitched in with 10. UConn opens in the second half with a quick strike with Tuck underneath.
Just a terrific screen set there to free up Morgan Tuck and get her into good position to go one-on-one.
And she has 11 points. So the big three are playing like the big three for the Huskies. Picked off by Jefferson, just too quick. You cannot make a lackadaisical pass with her anywhere in that area, Cole.
You can, and they come out in the zone, so they back off immediately and still able to make the defensive play.
Now you can go to a zone and, you know, show a little bit mercy. That one knocked in by Madeline from the corner. But they're still going to play hard all the time. And that's the mark of a Geno Auriemma team. Regardless of the score, they're always playing so hard.
Right. That's what's made this program great in my estimation.
Nice skip through there by Nurse, but can't convert. And on the line, they'll turn it over.
Let's take a look at the defensive dynamo that is Mariah Jefferson. Just ever so aware, even though they're in a zone, ball's going to come back to her side. She jumps the gun and makes herself an easy opportunity on the other end. Nicely done.
Mentioned this before, UConn is winning by about 41 points per game on average. As a team, they're shooting 53%. At the foul line, 80%, number one in the country. Tipped away. Stanilampro going for the save, but back over to UConn. Samuelson left open and knocks in the three. She has 20 points. 71-18.
I'm going to be fascinated when Jefferson and Stewie are gone, and we'll see what happens with Morgan Tuck. Where Geno deploys Katie Samuelson next year. We know her outstanding abilities as a three-point shooter, but at her size and abilities, she could go into the lane. I can't wait to see how he uses her a season from now.
Moraine gets fouled from behind with 7:58 to go here in the third quarter. That'll go against Stewart. We're talking about Geno Auriemma. His 10 national titles are more than all the active coaches in women's basketball combined.
What a group of extraordinary achievers. Of course, Phil Jackson, 11 titles in the NBA. Pat Summitt, who for so long was the standard bearer in women's college basketball. The great rivalry, the rivalry between Geno and Pat.
Coach Auriemma now in his 31st season. What he's done here is beyond extraordinary. Here's Tuck with a long three. Stewart got good position on the rebound, and a foul committed by Robert Morris. That'll go against Megan Smith. And that'll be her third personal foul, so she will go to the bench. It's actually going to be her fourth.
Yeah, she's their best defender, but obviously a major challenge. You can see the emotion getting to her, real frustration.
Natalie bouncing here for Ravelli. It's France to Italy. Two of the seven international players on their roster. Jones trying to take the baseline. The jump shot on the way. Stamolampou a little bit chilly here in the second half.
We're going to see another team in Duquesne in our second matchup that's got a high number of internationals as Stewie gets another three.
Well, she hits 41% from there. 18 points for Brianna Stewart, who is tied with the great Lou Alcindor of UCLA, is the only players with three Final Four Most Outstanding Player awards.
That's the beauty of what this achievement would be. If you think about all of John Wooden's teams, none of those players won four national championships because, of course, at that point when he was coaching, freshmen were not eligible to play.
Shot clock down to two, and it's going to expire without a shot. Natalie did not see it, so back over to UConn it goes.
There was a terrific story in USA Today by the terrific writer Christine Brennan talking about the dominance of UConn. She touched a little bit on the struggles at Tennessee without Pat Summitt. And I love one line in it where she says, until Geno steps away from UConn, behold the team that is alone in its dominance of the craft, the most underappreciated great organization in all of American sports. Would you agree with that? As you see what Geno has accomplished in terms of win streaks?
It's hard to deny. It really is. Trying for 70 straight wins today. What I really thought was important about that, it's a great line, about that column by Christine, I agree, was right on, was questioning why the rest of women's college basketball has been unable to catch up.
Right, and this is fascinating to me because I think the long view of history, when you look at a program like Notre Dame, how many titles would Muffet McGraw have? Remember, she's got one in 2001, the great Ruth Riley and Yale Ivy. How many titles would Muffet McGraw have if she were not coaching in Geno Auriemma's era?
She'd have several. Guarantee it, with the talent that she has had at Notre Dame. And she's had a spectacular career, a Hall of Fame career. Foul will go on Stewart, by the way, her second.
One thing that I would disagree with is you take a look at the dominance of the two programs at the top, and obviously UConn has surpassed Tennessee in terms of number of titles. One thing I would disagree with, and you hear a lot of coaches and outsiders say, well, he gets the best players every single year as Stewie gets another steal. Does he get some of them? Absolutely. Do other programs get some of them? No question about it. I think the brilliance of what UConn does, and specifically Geno Auriemma, is he is as selective as anyone in terms of the player that fits his dynamic. You've got to be able to check your ego at the door. You get stars who operate within the team standpoint, and he maximizes ability. I look at someone like Mariah Jefferson, who at one point gave nice move on a post. At one point, Geno Auriemma, early in her career, said to me, I'm not sure she's ever going to get where she needs to be. Mariah, you know, her best attribute was speed. Think about her growth from her sophomore year on.
Sure.
There's more to it than just having the best players.
Stewart launches, and a little bit too strong. A rare misfire today, the way UConn came out and just attacked Robert Morris. The Colonials come in with good credentials at 20 wins, 12 losses. Been a very highly successful program in the Northeast Conference. Shot clock down to 11. Backed away by Ravelli. Just so hard to get up a good pass. Natalie with a shot clock at 4. She's got to attack, trying to hook it up there, and it spins away. Well, you and I have attended more UConn practices with Geno Auriemma running the show than I think any broadcaster has attended anybody's practices, probably, over these last 10 years or so. The spin move by Samuelson went for the bank but missed it. And I would encourage other coaches to call him up and say, can I come by and watch your practice? High school coaches, even college coaches who might have him on the schedule, because he's very inviting, very generous about this. He wants you to come and watch.
No question about it. I'd also have my staff come to him in the summertime and just spend a weekend. Buy dinner, buy every meal, whatever. I don't care. Stewie gets what. You need to absorb some of the things that are making his program as great as it is.
Hand off for Nurse, and assist there for Jefferson. Because I'll say this, the vast majority of practices we watch, they're just flat different than UConn.
Did you see Sue Bird, of course, a great point guard who played here, who is now doing what we do and doing a terrific job of it. She talked about that. She said, there's times I go to shoot-arounds, and the one thought I'm having is, boy, this is fairly slow-paced and not as on point as a Connecticut shooter.
And it goes beyond what talent you have on the floor. As you said, they get a lot of great talent. Jefferson will lay that in. Nurse threading the needle on that pass.
And, Nick, and please understand that this is not an indictment on women's coaching, because I think you have got phenomenal coaches out there. I think Kim Mulkey, Muppet McGraw, Dawn Staley, these are coaches who are immensely talented and terrific at what they do.
They are. They're brilliant coaches.
Yes.
But you know what? If John Wooden were in his prime right now, I'd say the same thing. Yeah, go watch his practice, because he'll let you in. He'll certainly let you in the summertime to take a look at how they do things. Nurse can't stick the jump shot. And why wouldn't you take advantage when you're talking about one of the greatest all-time coaching minds in the history of basketball, which is what that man is?
No question about it. The Huskies are rolling. How about that pass? Nurse on a full sprint kicks it ahead to Mariah.
Slide, slide, stay down. Man, you get beat all the time on that. Lower.
Get him all the way up.
Slide, slide. Oh, that was terrible.
So we had Rebecca Lobo join us in the first half talking about this particular drill. And so you basically have to close out to 16 or 17 feet and get a stop. And if you don't get a stop on one side, Dave, you go to the opposite side of the floor. And this for Brianna Stewart early in her career was absolutely brutal. And Gino's point to her was, you want to be one of the best to ever do it, you better be able to guard and play defense to the same degree and level with the same passion that you play on the offensive end of the floor. And that's how you get greatness. You coach incredibly hard, you have high expectations, and you demand things of your players that maybe they don't think they have inside of them.
And now a noted defender, number one in blocks all time in the history at UConn.
And where's the improvement been in many areas for Brianna Stewart? But never in the course of her career until this year has she been able to jump passing lanes and have that kind of anticipatory ability to create opportunities.
Colonials had to hustle, the shot clock winding down, and Michaela Moraine knocks it in. Stewart on the bench right now, but on the cover of Sports Illustrated this week.
How cool is that?
For the third time in her career.
Really cool.
Samuelson fouled in the act of shooting a three. And speaking of sports, tonight after the NCAA Wrestling Championship, keep it locked to ESPN. Sports Center at night with Lisa Kearney and Kevin Connors. Coverage of the men's and women's tournaments, the NHL spring training, NBA. Tonight on ESPN, spring training, just a couple more weeks to run. Gino Auriemma, a huge baseball fan.
Yes.
Giant Phillies fan. And can't wait for Hardball.
At one point had season tickets to the Philadelphia Phillies in the Mike Schmidt era.
To Phillies fan, he might be able to wait a little longer. It's gonna be a long season for the Phillies. Shot clock now at 12 for the Colonials. Navarro can get that three in the air. Had to that time. Rebound picked off by Samuelson. UConn's largest margin of victory in the NCAA tournament was 72, by the way, back in 2001. Nurse back for Jefferson. Nurse thought about the three. Underneath for Collier. She's been finding it rough sledding underneath. The only Husky really who has today, the freshman.
She was lost on the defensive end. Makes up for it with that block. But boy, she almost got beat for a layup.
Janae Brown quickly on the other end, but knocked away.
Like, it's a good look. If you watch in the middle of the paint, Collier's got her head around. It isn't until her teammates communicate to her that she reacts and adjusts.
Timeout, Robert Morris. Coach Sal will take one here. He retires after today, and his son will become the new head coach at Robert Morris.
Can UConn's Brianna Stewart become the first female or male to win four straight basketball titles? This is the NCAA Women's Final Four.
Be sure to stay connected for this year's tournament at ESPNW. Today you can check out the quick dish and day one observations. How about Tennessee delivering in crunch time as well?
Well, we know how good that Wisconsin Green Bay program is. Just so outstanding. And how about Tennessee? Maybe a point of growth for Holly Warlick's team. Ability to close a game under duress. They have to win it after trailing heading into the fourth quarter.
Stenelampu threw that one away. Nurse with another steal. By the way, Stewart has eight steals already today for UConn. We talked about Sal Buscaglia, and at the end of the day today, he is going to be retiring, given the fact that Robert Morris will finish up their tournament run here at Storrs. And after a 38-year coaching career and over 700 wins, 13th season at Robert Morris as the head coach, his son Charlie right there to his right will become the new head coach.
How about this? Now, 1970 something, he goes, I'm in my late 20s, I'm working at a junior college, Hilbert College, and the athletics director comes up to him, he's just sitting in a cafeteria or some room there, and he said, I want to start a women's team and I want you to coach them. And he talked to us yesterday about the fact that he was raised by his mother and grandmother. And he doesn't find it coincidental that he ended up coaching women because the two greatest people in his life were his grandmother and his mom. It's pretty cool.
Great story. And he said, you know, when I started coaching, day one, it clicked. I just knew. Yeah. And that's what I was supposed to do. But getting a chance to turn the program over to one of your kids, extra special. Kalia reaches in and ties it up. To keep it on this end, it will be Robert Morris ball, but the defense continues to be rock solid for the Huskies.
And how about for Sal? You know, he's self-taught as a basketball coach. Had to learn it via clinics, VHS instructional videos. Remember when VHS was a thing?
Yeah. Some of us still have them. You just don't have the VCR anymore. It's gone the way of the dinosaur. So that's the end of three quarters. And UConn with a resounding lead, to put it mildly. Doris will be back with the play-by-play of the fourth quarter when we come back.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented.
So I had Shea Ralph and Marissa Mosley, the two outstanding and long-standing assistant coaches, tell me that each year UConn will put a highlight video together, and this play always makes it. You see multiple saves. Look at Rosati come out of nowhere. And the reason this play is important, it will develop. It'll eventually get into a situation where Rosati gets the ball back, sets the offense. They're going to get a nice post-to-post passing play. Our own 5-0 Rebecca Lobo is going to make a nice pass. It'll pick and roll. She's going to get one look, and she'll dump it down to Kara Walters. The reason this play is important is it makes every highlight video that they put together, because in Gino Auriemma's mind, that play typifies what his program was about. They are at home against Seton Hall. The score might have been a 25 to 30 point lead, but Rosati lays out in between multiple Seton Hall defenders who had a better opportunity for the ball, and instead they come up with it. And that typifies what this program is.
Nurse knocks one down to begin the fourth quarter. And that happens all the time. They have a lot of examples like that to go on that highlight reel. That's one of the most spectacular ones. But to your point, don't even think about what the score is. I mean, that game's virtually over by that point. They have a huge lead, and yet they're playing as if it's a national championship game and it's tied with 2 minutes to go. Nice move to her left there by Jocelyn Jones, the 5'10 senior.
I'll tell you, that young lady has comported herself well all day. She hit the deck in the first half. They were down about 30. Nice move.
Collier lines up a three, but too strong. Rebound tipped and controlled by the Colonials. 87-26. And the teams that will follow, Duquesne and Seton Hall, 9 versus 8, which will be our second game. They're beginning to get here to Gamble Pavilion.
Yeah, really interested in the matchup. I mean, obviously, anytime you have an 8-9, the expectation is it's two evenly matched teams. Stylistically, somewhat different. You've got a Robert Morris team that will run multiple action offense, sort of a read and react situation. You've got to anticipate. Seton Hall will try to use their athleticism to their advantage.
Two very good basketball teams to tangle. It should be a fun game. Those 8-9 games often come down to the last possession or two. Nurse long distance and buries it. She's really had a fine game, and I know the score,
right,
that buries a lot of things, but she has really played well.
Well, I think she's contributed in so many areas. She's been an exceptional passer today. Got 6 assists, 4 steals. Good communication here on the defensive end.
Well, she has a lot to live up to with all the athletes in her family. Man,
yeah,
is it something.
No question.
Great college players, great pro players. That is a family tree to behold. Under 7.5 remaining here. UConn came out of the gate today absolutely on fire and relentless and just poured it on quickly and built a gigantic lead. That's a blocking foul and the basket. So Collier's getting a lot of minutes. Going to the line, she has 7. But back to Kia Nurse. Take a look at this family tree. Now, you talk about a lot to live up to in all sports. She has a brother who's with the Edmonton Oilers. She has a sister who has played for 2 college teams at Division I. A cousin who plays hockey at Wisconsin. And her uncle is Donovan McNabb, a 6-time Pro Bowler.
Very good lineage, and I like her competitive spirit and how hard she plays.
And Miami with a big early lead against Wichita State, 23-6. It might be the fear of the snowstorm on the way. Hey, let's get a win in the bank very quickly, although the forecast has really weakened substantially. But for about 24 hours here, if you're watching from someplace other than the East Coast, we were thinking we were going to get buried. Three-pointer here by Ravelli, the senior from Italy. She has her first 3 points of the contest.
You can see at their level how they would have success. They run good sets. If they're a team that's put together well in terms of shooters, ball handlers, interior players, they've got a nice combination.
Collier getting a lot of minutes here now. Has 10 points. She's played well. A freshman from O'Fallon, Missouri. 2-time Missouri Gatorade Player of the Year. Anna McDonald's High School All-American. Tremendous credentials coming out of Missouri. Jones on a baseline. Threw it away. Ekmark will scoop that up. And stolen away by Stemma Lamprou. She goes around the back, and Ekmark takes it right back. Those two are playing their own game, and nearly turned over again. Butler off her fingertips and out of play. Well, the NCAA Women's Championship continues on ESPN2 today at 1:30 Eastern with round one action. You'll see coverage of Iona and Maryland, Middle Tennessee State and Florida State. Purdue, ranked number 11, taking on the 6-seed Oklahoma. And we have Seton Hall and Duquesne. And the Pirates are here from Seton Hall.
You look at that, the way Tennessee was able to conclude that game. First time all season they have trailed going into the fourth quarter, able to make all the necessary plays. Are they playing their best basketball at the right time? We shall see as this tournament marches on.
The Tennessee not ranked in the top 25. They fell out several weeks ago. But can they make a run? Stanley Lamprou on target, way downtown for 3.
She comes here because of a player that was a fellow countryman. Artemis Spinou was the first player from Greece to play for Robert Morris and graduated in 2014, but Stemma Lamprou was very familiar with her, huge name in Greece, and she said, you know what, I'm gonna go play where she played.
Sean gives it up and inside again for Collier, who's getting a lot of touches and now has 12 points. And quite an international pipeline to Robert Morris, the school just outside of Pittsburgh. Well, now the Huskies continue to push the tempo, trying to go to 33-0. Ekmark, that's going to be an offensive foul. as she cleared out on Stamma Lampreau and knocked her down.
That was the charge taken that he was talking about, because this disparity has been huge all day. Collier's going to add to that deficit, but nice little finish inside. You love how hard Robert Morris is playing. They've got 4:44 left of their season.
Time to check out today's Capital One Cup Impact Performance.
6'3" freshman from Huntington Beach, California. What a day. It included a very hard spill that we were concerned might keep her out. Well, it didn't. She makes the free throw. She came in with a reputation for this, the ability to make threes. Good job running the floor with her teammates. Off to a very good start in her first NCAA tournament game, Dave O'Brien.
I would say so. 22 points, 7 of 10. All smiles right now, which is great after the hit she took. Showing a lot of toughness there. And many in the UConn program, as DeShill hits, 5'9 sophomore from Salisbury, Maryland. Many believe she is going to be the next star in this program when Breanna Stewart leaves the stage, along with Mariah Jefferson. Heck mark on the baseline, not there, but once again, it's Collier to clean it up.
She's done a good job this afternoon, Collier.
So UConn, one more point to reach 100. Collier has 14, and Stamma Lampreau starting to heat up down the stretch here. She has another year to come. She's a junior, the guard from Greece.
I love her game, and anyone who can make the number of threes she has made in the course of her career and couple that with triple digits assists. The one thing I'd say for her moving forward is she also had triple digit turnovers. A year from now, Stamma Lampreau's got to cut that number down.
Nice fake and two for Chong to put them up at over 100 at 101. You knew that was coming the way this game started out. They would reach 100.
Does the crowd get something? Maybe not in an NCAA tournament game.
I'm always impressed by the fans who come to Gamble Pavilion when the score reaches this kind of level. They remain and they watch. And I mean, they watch in a very serious way. They want to see the UConn players perform well. And they really stick with it. 3:14 to go. On the road to the Frozen Four Ices up tomorrow, the 2016 NCAA Hockey Selection Special, presented by Northwestern Mutual at noon Eastern on ESPNU. And watch ESPN. Visit NCAA.com. It's the official online home for all 90 NCAA championships.
The defending national champion is the Providence College Friars, however.
I heard that.
They'll hold that title for a little while longer.
Heard that from you more than once. Very proud of your Friars.
I am.
And that'll drop in. Nice touch there by Leah Womack. So UConn to sail into round two. They'll be getting ready to take on the winner of Seton Hall and Duquesne. We'll have that game for you about a half hour after this one concludes from Gamble Pavilion.
Well, let me ask you this. And Rebecca Lobo and I were talking about this a little bit yesterday. The pursuit of this fourth title. How much more difficult could you see this being than a season ago for this Husky team?
You know, I thought coming into this,
yeah,
this particular tournament run, that it might be tough. And then I saw how prepared and how focused they were today. And I'm starting to lean the other way, like maybe they're going to have one of those just otherworldly runs where no one is going to touch them. I think the field is tougher. The
yeah.
field is tougher. Notre Dame gave them a heck of a run right here and put a scare into them right at Gamble Pavilion. I thought Maryland played a terrific 40 minutes against them. I'm thinking South Carolina has learned some things after getting knocked around by them twice back-to-back years.
Well, you've mentioned three teams that I believe, as a jumper goes, that I believe can win that game. But it's not important what I believe. It's important to those respective players believe that they can win. Notre Dame, you know, Muffet talks all the time about the change to the Big East elevated her program. And she has got the ability, with all of the weapons at her disposal, to score enough points to beat Connecticut. Because that's the first thing, as you can see, they've got 101 today. You've got to be able to put a number on the board in terms of your offense. Breanna Turner did not play in that matchup.
That's
she
right.
is at the top of the list, behind Breanna Stewart, for National Player of the Year. As you see what the Irish have done against everybody but UConn, 104-1.
And then, I thought in the game here at Gamble that
yeah.
Muffet McGraw coached a terrific game and really had them on edge.
No question about it. And the outstanding freshman, Ms. Mabry from my high school, Manasquan, tore it up on the offensive end of the floor, came in fearless. You've got to be able to do that. I think South Carolina has the advantage in the post. Morgan Tuck did an exceptional job on Elena Coates, but can they get to their post game? Will their guards make good enough decisions in a matchup should that play out?
Daniel Lemper is short there. I also want to see Baylor.
Yes, me too.
And Baylor is another that has to be thinking they have a serious shot. But everybody goes into the tournament hoping, you know, the legits, the other number one seeds, they've got a shot at UConn. And then what happens when you get to the Final Four in recent years?
Yeah.
So we'll see if it's a different story come Indianapolis. Right now, the Huskies off to a flying start on their home floor in their first NCAA tournament game. Stamolamper with another miss there. 101-45. As the Huskies turn it over for one of the rare occasions in this game. UConn turned Robert Morris over 20 times in the first half. And a timeout. Seton Hall is getting ready to take the floor here. In the locker room and getting set. We'll hear some of that when we get ready for our second game, which is coming up here on ESPN2.
That's Anthony Bozzella, who has done a terrific job since he took over that Seton Hall program. Back-to-back NCAA tournaments, went to the NIT the year before that.
And Tony told us yesterday at practice, we want to get to the point where we're going every year, and they're on their way doing that back to the NCAA tournament. Also in the bracket, Mississippi State and Michigan State, the 5-4 moving on, and they will meet on Sunday afternoon.
Now, you know that Michigan State is one of the outstanding defensive teams in the country. I mentioned this young lady, Ariel Powers, who plays for Michigan State, a potential opponent. Imani Boyette, the Texas center, who again, remember, Texas played them a season ago. I think that is so important to have had experience against UConn. And then Courtney Williams, yes, UConn is familiar with her. Three times those teams have faced off. And something that Rebecca said, and I can't remember if this was on the selection show, but I remember her and Kara discussing this. UConn has not lost many halves over the last several years. The one team that has had the advantage in several halves is South Florida. So, listen, this is the pressure is going to build. The longer this goes, the more media attention happens, Dave. These kids are aware that they're chasing history, and that's what I was speaking about. Three of the 19 times by South Florida.
Yeah.
You know, I know that these kids are accustomed to pressure. How much of a factor is that as this wears on, the increased attention?
Rivelli with a nice bank shot there to make it 101-47. She has 8 points in this one. The Huskies on their way to 33-0 and also a 70-game winning streak that will tie their number two all-time winning streak. Of course, number one is 90 in a row.
And our final opportunity here, let's say a congratulations for Sal Buscaglia, who has stepped aside after so many years, successful years coaching women's basketball. Our gratitude to him for his time devoted.
And we'll get to know his son, Charlie, very well. He's 36 years old and will take the reins of the program next year.
Yeah. I think a terrific pick. And remember, Charlie went through the process. This was not sort of just granted to him. Met with the board of directors, met with the president, met with the selection committee.
Final seconds here in the fourth quarter. UConn winning a game against the 16 seed and are now about to be 33-0 on the season. Number one overall seed and going for their fourth consecutive national championship. UCLA, the men, won seven in a row in the 60s and early 70s. UConn trying to make it 11 titles for the program and off to a great, great start here today as they beat Robert Morris 101-49 for a 70th consecutive win. And that's a marvelous moment there. Coach retiring and a legend moving on. And they're pals, as Gino is with so many coaches. Once again, the final score, UConn 101 and Robert Morris 49. Our bracket as we take a look.
Now that I'm able to go in the champions locker room, it's a feeling of prestige to be part of the club of Masters Champions.
Opening day and night. Seven games, 2 days. Clayton will be there with nasty stuff. Kutch with all five tools. And Trout, who knows what he'll do next? Baseball is back, and not a moment too soon. Games all day, April 3rd and 4th on ESPN and streaming live on Watch ESPN and the ESPN app, presented by Scotts.
Let me see the spoon. Actually, give me the fork. Thanks. I don't know. What do you think?
That cheese looks a little saucy. I'd go a spoon.
All right. Yeah, spoon.
The rest of the country.
You either get in position to rebound or get back. The only way that we're going to win this is if we pound it, pound it, pound it.
If you want to be the best, you got to beat the best. Anything can happen.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship, Sweet 16, begins tonight at 7 on ESPN, presented by Capital One.
Texas A&M, Alabama, Missouri, Vanderbilt, Wednesday on the SEC ESPN Network. Wednesday, the Aggies show their talent.
Here's House down the lane. Wow.
The Tide play with heart.
Thompson has it. Boom!
Texas A&M, Alabama, Wednesday at 7 on the SEC ESPN Network.
Buy the Quicksilver card from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day. And in part by Verizon. Join a better network because better.
You're not gonna fit. Maybe you should just get a ride with Kevin.
Walking on that clubhouse. That's the gold standard in this sport.
The aura of it, Bobby Jones, the whole thing is just something that's very, very special.
Now that I'm able to go in the champions locker room, it's a feeling of prestige to be part of the club of Masters champions.
No matter how many times you played it, you get goosebumps, you get pumped up, you get excited.
Basketball Championship, Sweet 16, begins Friday at 7 on ESPN.
Scott Van Pelt
has joined the conference.
Fellas, sorry I'm a little bit late. Hope I didn't keep you guys. Hello? Anybody there? Hello? Am I the first or what? Hello? Anybody there? Always cancel these things and no one tells me. Scott Van Pelt
has left the conference.
Opening day and night. 7 games, 2 days. Baseball is back and not a moment too soon. Games all day, April 3rd and 4th on ESPN.
Hey, fellas, you using boat blenders?
Soup and sandwich and cannonballs. And clean and real and looking good. And sandwich and soup. And a new personal best. And a little help. And soup and sandwich and study group. Good, clean food pairs well with anything. Try the clean pairings menu at Panera. Food as it should be. Soup and sandwich and clean and real. And feeling good. Sort of. And 500 calories or less. The clean pairings menu at Panera. Food as it should be.
I love walking on that clubhouse.
The aura of it is just something that's very, very special.
Now that I'm able to go in the champions locker room, it's a feeling of prestige to be part of the club of Masters champions.
Opening day, April 3rd and 4th on ESPN.
Sitting in front of a camera all day is harder than it looks. So we bring in an expert to help us with our posture and delivery.
I want you to imagine a little string pulling your head up.
Where's the string?
You're holding a towel under your armpits, eyes on the teleprompter. Mm-hmm. Don't look up to see the highlight. Mm-hmm. Look through the highlight.
You need a boatload of patience.
You know what? Forget everything I just said. Just be yourself. How's that feel?
Feels pretty good.
I like it, too.
The Women's Basketball Championship, Sweet 16, begins Friday at 7 on ESPN.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
I love to take pictures that engage people and to connect us with the wonderment of nature. The detail on this surface book is amazing. With the tiger image, the saliva coming off, you've got this turn, and that's why I need this kind of resolution and computing power. Being able to use a pen like this on a screen directly with the image, it just gives me a different relationship to it. And I can't do that on my Mac. This is brilliant for me.
Intelligent all-new Audi A4 is here.
That sign says,
eat more ch. What is ch?
Well, it's the start of a word. Something like eat more cheese or eat more chili.
Chocolate, eat more chocolate.
No, it's chowder.
Chickpeas.
Chimichangas.
Cheesecake.
Chewing gum. It could be chewing gum.
That's not how you spell chicken. I'm pretty sure.
These former presidents are discussing the finer points of American engineering, like the most advanced available all-wheel drive system and the available 363 horsepower V8 engine.
I don't know why you asked me to meet you here to talk about these things. And I fall for it every time.
I guess they haven't discovered the available Uconnect hands-free phone yet. We'll come back to that. Trade in and get 2,500 bonus cash plus 2,000 cash allowance plus 500 bonus cash when you finance Chrysler 200.
Jim Beam and Apple have come together to make history. Introducing new Jim Beam Apple. Poured over ice and served with club soda and a fresh lemon wedge to make it crisp, refreshing. Jim Beam Apple and Soda.
Men need to prepare themselves. New Nivea Men Cream. Super fast absorbing and non-greasy. Nivea makes you feel good in your skin. New Nivea Men Cream. Crafted just for you. Nivea Men. It starts with you. Get your free sample at NiveaMenUSA.com.
Oh, this is amazing. Right, Lil Wayne?
Shh. I can't talk right now, Wesley Snipes. I'm delivering this baby elephant.
The new virtual reality-powered Galaxy S7 Edge.
Hi, I'm Christy.
And I'm Jess.
And we are the Bug Chicks. We're a nano business.
Windows 10 really helps us get the word out about how awesome bugs are.
Kids learn to be brave and curious, and all kids speak a language of bug.
Hey, Cortana, find my Katydid video.
Oh, this is so good. If you're trying to teach a kid about a proboscis, just sketch it on the screen. I don't have a touch screen on my Mac. I'm jealous of that. You put a big bug in a kid's hands and change their worldview.
Introducing lunch at Outback every bloomin' day. Hurry in for all your Outback favourites, plus Aussie tacos, savoury ribeye melt, and our delicious burgers. With lunch combinations starting at just $6.99. It's lunch at last every day at Outback.
The NCAA Women's Championship, presented by Capital One, is brought to you by Verilox, never compromise your vision, and USAA, proudly serving the military community and their families for more than 90 years.
Why do we do it? Why do we spend every waking moment thinking about people? Why are we so committed to keeping you connected? Why combine performance with a conscience? Why innovate for a future without accidents? Why do any of it? Why do all of it? Because if it matters to you, it's everything to us. The S60 sedan from Volvo.
Play the greatest games lineup in Xbox history.
This is shaving. A blade. Many blades. Sharp blades.
Blades here, blades there, some more over there.
Oh, that's not another blade. This is shielding. With lubrication here. And here. The new Gillette with Pro Shield lubrication before and after the blades. Shields from irritation for a close, comfortable shave. The new Pro Shield from Gillette, the best a man can get. And one Pro Shield refill gets you up to 1 month of shaves.
All online tax companies offer pretty much the same thing. But with TaxSlayer.com, you could be the envy of your friends with a random bowling trophy we found on the internet. Everyone has to do their taxes, but not everyone can win sweet swag like this.
There are a few who move toward the sounds of chaos. Forged in the crucible of training, they are the first to move toward the sounds of tyranny, injustice, and despair. They are the few. The proud, the Marines.
Today,
where is the beef?
Means something different. Some use beef frozen from far away. But Wendy's believes the juiciest hamburgers are made from fresh beef, raised
right here.
Land of the beef, home of the deliciously different Dave's Double.
Every day you read headlines about businesses being hacked and intellectual property being stolen. That is cybercrime, and it affects each and every one of us. Microsoft created the Digital Crimes Unit to fight cybercrime. We use the Microsoft Cloud to visualize information so we can track down the criminals.
When it comes to the cloud, trust and security are paramount.
We're building what we learn back into the cloud to make people and organizations safer.
At Straight Talk Wireless, we believe your tax refund should last all year long. Don't waste it on a pricey wireless plan. Lose the contracts, mystery fees, and overages. Switch to Straight Talk to get coverage on America's largest and most dependable 4G LTE networks for half the cost. That's right, half. Get any of the latest Samsung phones or bring your own phone. Unlimited talk, text, and data is $45 a month and nothing more. Straight Talk Wireless, only at Walmart.
Thank you.
experts choose Goodyear. And everything we learn making these tires inspires what we roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven.
Opening day and night. 7 games, 2 days. Baseball is back. Games all day, April 3rd and 4th on ESPN.
Presented by the Quicksilver card from Capital One. Earn unlimited 1.5% cash back every purchase, every day. And in part by the all-new Audi A4.
If you misplaced your Discover card, you can use Freeze It to prevent new purchases on your account in seconds. And once you find it, you can switch it right on again.
You're back.
Freeze It from Discover. Get it at discover.com.
This is our point of view. If there's a better way, take it. If there's a claim, stake it. If there's a perception, escape it. If there's an open road, never waste it. And if there's a dream to be chased, chase it. This is what we make, and this is how we make it.
What makes the jump shot of a Wooden Award finalist different?
Balance.
Elbows.
Eyes.
Follow through.
Like the fresh, never frozen beef that makes Dave's Double deliciously different.
Sometimes I don't know where I end and the commercial begins. There it is.
This has been the Wooden Award presented by Wendy's presentation of Billosophy, presented by Jay Billis.
Vote for the best player in college basketball at WoodenAwardVote.com.
Moment while I search roof repair. Sure, I can call Ralph. Calling Ralph. Looking up vacation rentals in St. Bart's. Okay, here are...
Think of it as a 7-seat theater for an action-packed thriller. The all-new Audi Q7.
New Tidy Cats Lightweight 4-in-1 fights mess right. Attacks 3 strong litter box odors. Plus, locks clumps tight. And now, it's light. Every home, every cat. There's a Tidy Cats for that.